Did you know that the conditions chickenpox and shingles are both caused by the same virus? That virus is known as varicella zoster virus. And an individual can only have shingles after they have had a chickenpox infection. So let's talk about chickenpox first. Now, chickenpox primarily infects kids. However, the rates of those infections have dramatically decreased over the past two decades due to the vaccine that was introduced in the late 1990s. However, chickenpox is characterized by those small, itchy bumps all over one's body, but it can also be associated with fever and headache. Now, those small, itchy bumps actually go through three different phases. The first phase is just a small pink bump, which then moves on into the second phase, where that bump gets a little bit bigger and is filled with fluid. But it then moves on to the third and final stage, where the bump begins to dry out and scab over. And that's really important because all of those bumps need to be scabbed over to prevent further infection of that virus to unvaccinated or uninfected individuals. And one can pass on that virus through the contact with the blisters, as well as through coughing and one's own saliva. But once an individual has already had chickenpox once, it's highly unlikely that they will ever have a repeat infection. But that's where shingles comes into play. And that's because the varicella zoster virus actually never leaves one's body after they've already had chickenpox. It stays dormant inside of one's nerve cells for the rest of their life. And it can become reactivated later on in life, leading to shingles. And shingles is characterized by this band of very painful blisters all over one's torso and or even one's face. But an individual that has shingles won't pass on shingles to another individual. But if they come in contact with someone who has never had chickenpox and never received a chickenpox vaccine, they could pass on the virus, leading to an individual having chickenpox, but now as an adult. And it's estimated that without any precautionary measures, about one third of all individuals who have ever had a chickenpox infection would develop shingles later on in their life. And that's why later on we'll be discussing the shingles vaccine, how one can protect themselves and their community from this condition.